So the first chapter of your syllabus actually solid state, and we had seen, if you remember, the gaseous state topic for 11th standard course, where we had seen Boyle's law, Charles' law, and other things. So this is the second state we are going to study, that is solid state. There are around 5 units in this topic, and I think the first one is going to be the easiest among all, where most of the things you already know. Second unit onwards, we will have totally new things to study about solid state. So we will start with, first of all, the basic states of matter, as you know. And we know there are 3 states of matter at regular room temperature, that is solid, liquid, and gas. Now, besides these 3 states, we know there are 2 more states also possible, but they are only at special conditions of temperature, pressure, and other conditions. So we are not going to study those plasma state and fifth state. We are going to only focus about solid state in this topic. Now the question is, when we talk about liquid and gas, there is one very common thing in them, that is the ability to flow. That is why liquid and gases in technical terms are called fluids. Usually in English, when we say a term fluid, we always feel liquid. But gas also can travel from one point to another quite easily. That is why technically gases also come under the category of fluids. We are only going to right now focus about solids, and you can see the examples which are written in this point: diamond, metal, plastics, etc. Now these are, although they are solids, they are of not same type. Everyone has its own characteristics, something different. So what makes a solid different from a liquid and gas? So you can see the definition. A true solid is that type of matter which has, number 1, rigidity, number 2, definite shape, number 3, definite volume, and number 4, long range order. We are going to now take details of almost all the thing, more focused on long range order. This is a new term for you. So go through the definition once again. A true solid is defined as that type of matter which has rigidity, definite shape, definite volume, and long range of order. So we will talk about these points, take up some characteristics also. First question is, why certain substances are solid in state? Or rather, what makes a difference in solid from a liquid or from a gas? We have to answer it scientifically. And for that, we need to take help of the energies present in the molecules. State of the matter depends on 2 types of energies or forces. Number 1, intermolecular force. The force which is present between 2 particles. Now, they may be atoms, they may be molecules, they may be clusters of atoms, anything. That is intermolecular force. Number 2, thermal energy present within that or in the surrounding of it. Now, if thermal energy is high, temperature is high, particles will try to move faster. They will try to go away from each other. So, when low temperature is there, thermal energy is low, intermolecular forces are very strong, then particles can come close together. They will remain at fixed positions. They will not be able to move from here to there. At that time, substance goes in solid state. So, in simple summary, when intermolecular forces are stronger than thermal energy, substance becomes solid in state. Go through this whole paragraph. This is a paragraph I've taken from NCERT, and in once in JEE, true or false, and once in NEET, this question was asked. Any doubt about this point before we go ahead? Remember the sentence in this one, summary of this whole slide: intermolecular forces stronger than thermal energy. That is the reason for becoming one substance in solid state. Let us put now general characteristics of solid state. And most of these points you perhaps already know. Almost nothing is new. First, solids have definite mass, definite volume, and definite shape. In very few condition, the shape of the solids can be changed. Maybe something like in elastic substances like rubber. Solids are rigid, incompressible under normal conditions. They have obviously very strong intermolecular force of attraction. The distance between the two atoms, distance between two ions, or distance between two molecules is going to be very short. So technically they say short interatomic or interionic or intermolecular distance. So what is the difference in these three things? Where do you find them? If the solid is made up of only atoms, for example, graphite or diamond, it's only made up of carbon atoms. So we have to use the term interatomic at that time. If you are talking about a solid like NaCl, sodium chloride, then it comes out to be interionic. If you are talking about a solid crystal like glucose or sucrose, intermolecular. What we said right now, the examples, they are called constituent particles. This word will come again and again in the topic, constituent particles. What is the smallest particle in the crystal? So these constituent particles have fixed positions. They may oscillate about the mean position, but cannot leave their position. They can oscillate, but they cannot leave the position. Any doubt about any of these properties?
So, sir, sodium alone will be only interatomic?
Yes, only metal, sodium, magnesium, interatomic. Sodium chloride, interionic.
So, are interconvertible compounds considered in this solids? Like,
means?
So, for example, like water, so like ice. And
so
like
we have to only consider ice at that time. So, in ice,
yeah, so it's considered
molecular. Because there are H2O molecules, correct? We cannot consider water vapor and liquid water at that time. So ice, if you consider, then the smallest constituent particle becomes H2O molecule at that time.
So, sir, alloys will have intermolecular?
Alloys, it will be interatomic because metals will be present in atomic state. Correct.
Okay.
Alloys will have, suppose, copper and gold and copper, suppose, alloy. So gold ka atoms, copper ka atoms. So force of attraction between them will be present. Right? Now we classify the solids. So first type of solids which we encounter are crystalline. And we will be studying, in fact, in the whole topic, crystalline solids only. So crystalline solids, definitely. Now this diagram, what you see, is a diagram of silica, that is quartz. So you can see the red circles, what you see, they are silicon atoms, oxygen atoms, and the small ones are perhaps silicon atoms. So this crystalline solid will be first of all homogeneous solid. Constituent particles are arranged in a definite repeating pattern. A beautiful geometry can be seen in any crystalline solid. Of course, geometry will change. And what sort of geometry every type can show is our unit number 2 in the next lecture. Examples simple are given: diamond, NaCl, potassium sulfate, any salt you can write for that. Opposite of crystalline solid, if you know, is called amorphous solid. Amorphous solid is going to be absolutely haphazard manner substance. So here, constituent particles are not at all arranged in a regular manner. That is called amorphous solid. Plastic, glass, rubber, butter, starch molecules, these are all starch solid. They are in amorphous form. So let us take in details the types of these things. So first property of difference we are going to see between them is isotropy and anisotropy. Every year when I teach this, students at the end get little bit confused because the terms and the crystalline amorphous are actually opposite of each other. So listen to this very carefully and keep this in mind very properly. Isotropy indicates uniformity in all the directions. In solid state, isotropy indicates identical values of physical properties, which we can measure like refractive index, electrical conductivity, etc. amorphous solids are isotropic in nature. Understand it very carefully. This is, you can see, an amorphous solid drawn, where particles are not in a definite geometrical manner. And suppose I am measuring, let us say, interference of light or diffraction of light. So suppose my light beam in the experiment goes in this vertical direction. So when it is going this way, it can touch or it can interfere with maybe this red circle, green circle, sometimes no circle, sometimes two red circles, red atoms, anyhow it will go. Maybe in this direction also, it can go in a random manner. So whenever amorphous substances are there, they are called isotropic. And if you measure these physical properties in any direction, you will get the same value of the physical property. Matlab, refractive index, if you measure in this vertical manner or in this manner, values come out to be same for isotropic. On the other hand, anisotropy means the value of the property depends upon direction of the measurement. For example, check this structure. It's a very orderly arrangement of green atoms and red atoms. If you are measuring in this direction, it will be due to these red atoms only. If you measure in this direction, it will be due to green atoms only. So as the direction of measurement changes, values will change. This is called anisotropy. The confusion happens is because of this point, that crystal over here, crystalline structure, is very disciplined. So we feel it should be iso, similar. It's not. The measurement is isotropic. The structure is disciplined or indisciplined. So I repeat the concept again. Amorphous structures are indisciplined structures. The measurement come out to be same. Crystalline structures are disciplined structures. Measurement depends upon direction. This is called anisotropic measurement. Please read up these two para. For exams, this is a very important point. There have been short notes asked on this in boards, MCQs, true or false, all these things they are asked.
So if we say that the atoms are interfering with the reflective index.
Actually, yes, atoms in fact reflect. The measurements of light radiation especially are due to the arrangement of atoms only. So that's why when atoms change, that means your direction of beam changes, the direction changes. You have a chapter in physics about modern physics, where you will be doing this experiment of diffraction of light beam using nickel crystal. So there it is found that when you put an angle of say 50 degree, diffraction recorded is something different. When you record at 45 degree, the diffraction is something else. So there, you know, you will be doing actually in this experiment, this part. So angle changes, measurement changes. Because the atoms which we encounter totally differ sometimes. Abhi metal mein kya hota hai? Metal mein sabhi ke atoms same hote hai. Toh itna farak nahin padega. But suppose it is sodium chloride. So suppose this is chlorine and this is sodium. Sodium ke wajah se jo light ka interaction hoga, wo alag. Chloride ke wajah se alag aayega. So you get actually different readings in that way.
Sir, glass is an amphoteric solid or crystalline?
Kaun sa?
Glass.
Glass is amorphous. It is not crystalline. Hum log karenge abhi amorphous ka paragraph lenge, to hum log glass ka mention hai usme.
So okay, sir. So we are saying that atoms only are the main reasons for the reflective index.
Arrangement of atoms.
Arrangement. Yes.
Arrangement of atoms make the whole play basically.
So, person, if suppose you go from one direction and there is like red, green.
Yeah.
And correct. From other direction you go green, red.
That then depends. Yeah, depends on the size of atoms, the angle, so many things.
So, sir, then like that isotropy also may amphoteric should, sorry, amorphous should not be isotron. Because
no, the measurement the thing is, here since amorphous may, since there is no arrangement only anyhow, so measurement in any direction doesn't make a difference. since arrangement is regular in crystalline, that makes a difference. So any direction you go, the atoms encountered are totally different every time. That is why it is called isotropic. So arrangement doesn't control the measurement here. Here the arrangement controls because we encounter different atoms. Here it is totally haphazard. So practically it is found that in any direction you go, measurement comes out to be same. Have you all done this light sections and all in physics? Diffraction, interference, especially interference.
Yes, sir. No, sir.
इंटरफेरेंस में आपका वेव थियरी एंड ऑल का डायग्राम्स वगैरह सब है उसमें उसमें वो आपको ये सब चीज वहां इनफैक्ट ज्यादा अच्छा समझ में आएगा. यू हैव दैट यंग्स डबल स्लिट एक्सपेरिमेंट.
यस,
वहां पे ये सब चीज इनफैक्ट रिक्वायर्ड है. यू गेट यू नो ब्राइट बैंड्स एंड डार्क बैंड्स एंड ऑल. सो यू नो देयर दिस इज ऑल गोइंग टू एनकाउंटर सिमिलर थिंग्स.
सर, हां, then the experiment, the source can be anything, right? Like
we are not going in those detail. That is the physics detail, coherent source and monochromatic source, and that we are not concerned in chemistry. We are assuming that it might be coherent source and we are going to have monochromatic light for radiation. That those details physics people see, hum log ko interest nahi usme. Chalo, next is short and long range order. This term we encountered in the very first or second slide somewhere. तो अभी इसका एक्सप्लेनेशन डेफिनेशन में हम लोग ने किया था. क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड्स लार्ज नंबर ऑफ स्मॉल क्रिस्टल्स आर इमेजिन्ड टू हैव अ प्रॉपर ज्योमेट्रिकल शेप. सो फॉर एग्जांपल व्हेन यू कंसीडर दिस सेम डायग्राम व्हिच आई शोड यू इन द बिगिनिंग, दिस इज क्रिस्टलाइन क्वार्ट्ज. इफ यू टेक अप अ स्मॉल पार्ट, इट लुक्स लाइक अ हेक्सागन, यू कैन सी, एंड दिस हेक्सागन इज रिपीटेड एन नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स इन ऑल द डायरेक्शंस. This is what we call as long range order. So in long range order, a proper geometrical pattern is repeated at a long distance continuously without any change. On the other hand, amorphous solids don't have any geometry at all. You imagine perhaps maybe I can see this particular part here. And exactly this geometry is not seen anywhere as such. That is called short range order. So this is quartz, which is crystalline. This is quartz, another allotrope, which is amorphous variety. Go through this. Any doubt? See if you follow short range order and long range order. Geometry of the crystal repeated for a longer duration of length is called long range order. Very, very simple. So we now summarize the crystalline solid general characteristics. This is the answer I have just copied from GTB. ये आपको exam में short note करके आ सकता है. अभी जितना terms देखा, उसी का ये summary है. There is a regularity, periodicity of arrangement, and the ordered arrangement is called the long range order. Crystalline solids will have a sharp melting point. They will melt exactly at the given temperature only. We have seen already the term crystalline solids are anisotropic, different values in different directions. We have seen it already, and few examples are mentioned here. This can be asked in exam for as a short note for 2 marks. Similar answer for amorphous, but now all opposite points. Randomly arranged, the arrangement is over a short period of length, so it's called short range. Now this is where we talk about glass. Amorphous solids do not have sharp melting points. You know, if you start heating an amorphous solid, it will melt over a range of temperature. So perhaps 600 degree ko melting chalu hoga, 650 tak melt hote hi rahega, fir 650 ko wo pura melt hoga. So this is what we say, they become gradually and continuously become soft, then start to flow, that means they become liquid. That is why amorphous solids are termed false solids. Pseudo is false solids, also called supercooled liquids. Abhi iska sabse best example aapko milega. If you have some old houses and in the windows, glass panes are attached. So in these ones, what you find is by absorbing heat from sun rays, ये ग्लास धीरे धीरे नीचे की तरफ फ्लो होता है, और कभी भी ये ग्लास अगर टूटेगा तो आपको दिखेगा कि ऊपर का ग्लास ब्रेक होगा और नीचे का ग्लास वैसे ही वुडन फ्रेम में चिपका हुआ रहता है. वी फील दिस इज बिकॉज ऑफ ग्रेविटी, कि ऊपर का ग्लास ब्रेक हो गया, नीचे का ग्लास ऐसे ही है. नहीं, ऐसा नहीं होता है. इट इज बिकॉज ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम द अपर ग्लास हैज फ्लोन एंड मूव्ड डाउनवर्ड. सो वो नीचे का बहुत थिक होके ग्लास फ्रेम में अटक जाता है और उसको निकालना भी बहुत डिफिकल्ट होता है. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट अ पीरियड लाइक लॉन्ग पीरियड. इट्स नॉट लाइक आज घर आपने बनाया, नया ग्लास विंडोज डाला है, 10 दिन बाद. नहीं, दिस इज लाइक 10 years, 15 years, 20 years old glass panes I am talking about. We have also seen the term isotropic and few examples. Here is the glass, what you were asking earlier. Glass, plastic, rubber, these are all metal, metalloid ke alloy come under this. Lekin metal, metal alloy will come under crystalline. Please be very careful. Metal, metalloid alloy come under amorphous. Metal, metal alloy come under crystalline. Even metal, non-metal also come under crystalline. All these points are summarized in one single manner over here.
Sir, amalgam will be this, no?
Liquid amalgam is in this? Liquid state. Amalgams are in liquid. Kyunki usme mercury zyada rahega, to wo liquid state mein jata hai. Flowing rehta hai. Amalgam kabhi kabhi flowing reh sakta hai, fluid jaisa. Please read up these points. We come to the types of crystalline solids or how substances can be classified in crystalline way. So first term is called isomorphism. So here two or more solids can have same crystal structure. They are called isomorphous. Two or more solids have same crystal structure. That is called isomorphous. Their chemical composition will follow a same atomic ratio also. Let me give example to understand this. Sodium fluoride and magnesium oxide. They have sodium fluorine or magnesium oxygen ratio as 1:1, and they show a quite similar structure. So you can see sodium and fluorine are in the ratio 1:1. Alternately, there is Na and F. Same way, magnesium and oxygen alternately have similar crystalline structure. So NaF and MgO are called isomorphous substances. Same way here, second example, Na, N and 3 oxygen ratio is 1:1:3. Same is found with Ca, C and 3 oxygen. So this is called isomorphous structures. We can have an opposite thing of it. That is called... bolo.
So this won't be the same in all the structures.
No, not at all. Not at all. If you, for example, take NaCl, it has a different structure altogether. So isomorphism mein aapko actually structure ke bare mein pata hona chahiye. Aap log formula dekh ke nahi likh sakte. So jaise ye do pairs jo example ke diye, aap log isko by heart karke rakho. Kyunki agar maine socha NaF, NaCl, they don't have a similar structure at all. They have totally different structure. In fact, NaCl aur KCl ka bhi structure alag hai. तो ये जो स्ट्रक्चर्स होते हैं वो लोग एक्सरे मेथड से फाइंड आउट करते हैं. हम लोग को सिर्फ बाय हार्ट करने हैं. वी कैनॉट प्रेडिक्ट ए स्ट्रक्चर एट ऑल. ओके, हम लोग ये टॉपिक में लगभग 8 या 9 अलग अलग स्ट्रक्चर सीखने वाले हैं. तो दोज आर दी पिक्यूलर एग्जांपल्स एंड दे कैनॉट बी जनरलाइज्ड एट ऑल. राइट, सो आप लोग ये एग्जाम्पल एग्जाम्स के लिए बाय हार्ट करो आइसोमॉर्फिज्म का. अपने मन से कोई भी एग्जाम्पल मत लिखना, वो गलत जाएगा एंड यू विल गेट 0 mark फॉर द एग्जाम्पल. Please be careful about it. Right? Second is polymorphism. Polymorphism means single substance can exist in different crystalline form. Material is same, lekin uske alag alag forms hote hain. Ye aapko already pata hai, in fact. एलिमेंट्स में अगर पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म है तो उसे हम लोग कहते हैं एलोट्रॉपी. जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल कार्बन एज डायमंड, कार्बन एज ग्रेफाइट. अभी ये दोनों कार्बन ही है लेकिन दोनों के क्रिस्टल स्ट्रक्चर्स अलग हैं. ये हो गई एलिमेंट की बात. अभी ये कंपाउंड में भी पॉसिबल है. सो पॉलीमॉर्फ्स कैन बी फॉर्म्ड अंडर डिफरेंट कंडीशंस. जैसे कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट के, अभी कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट मॉलिक्यूल है तो उसके दो फॉर्म्स है. एक है कैल्साइट क्रिस्टल, दूसरा है एरागोनाइट क्रिस्टल. अभी कैल्साइट क्रिस्टल अगर आपको थोड़ा बहुत मेमोरी अच्छा है तो याद आएगा ये हम लोगों ने निकल प्रिज्म बनाने के लिए यूज किया था. इसको हम लोग ने काट के निकल प्रिज्म बनाते हैं और निकल प्रिज्म से हम लोग प्लेन पोलराइज लाइट क्रिएट करके ऑप्टिकल एक्टिविटी डिस्कवर करते हैं. तो देखो दोनों में टोटल डिफरेंट है. दिस इज कैल्साइट क्रिस्टल एंड दिस इज एरागोनाइट. दोनों का केमिकल फॉर्मूला है कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट. देख के लगेगा भी नहीं इतने दोनों अलग दिखते हैं. एनी डाउट अबाउट दिस? यू नीड टू रिमेंबर दीज पर्टिकुलर एग्जाम्पल्स मेंशन्ड इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक. The advantage of taking these lectures on slideshow is I can show all these examples. Last batches में हम लोग खाली क्लासरूम में बड़बड़ करते थे. अभी आपके लिए स्लाइड्स पे अच्छे अच्छे एग्जाम्पल सामने, फोटोग्राफ काफी इजीली मिलते हैं. अभी so, बोलो जैसे अभी उन्होंने डिस्कवर किया है कि ग्रेफाइट को हम लोग ने अगर बहुत प्रेशर के अंडर और हाई टेम्परेचर के अंडर रखा तो ग्रेफाइट कैन बी कन्वर्टेड इंटू डायमंड एंड इवन डायमंड कैन बी कन्वर्टेड इंटू ग्रेफाइट. बट दैट बिकम्स एन आर्टिफिशियल प्रोसेस. नॉर्मल रूम टेम्परेचर पे क्या होता है, दे आर सेपरेटली एग्जिस्टिंग सो दे आर स्टेबल एलोट्रॉप्स. बट एवरी एलोट्रॉप कैन बी कन्वर्टेड इंटू ईच इंटरकन्वर्टेबल आर प्रेजेंट. अल्फा सल्फर, बीटा सल्फर, येलो फॉस्फोरस, रेड फॉस्फोरस, दे ऑल एग्जिस्ट लाइक दैट. इंटरकन्वर्टेबल रहते हैं सब. यहाँ पे भी ऐसा ही है. क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ सॉलिड्स विच वी सॉ राइट नाउ एज फर्स्ट क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड्स एंड देन अमॉर्फस सॉलिड्स. अभी इसमें अमॉर्फस सॉलिड्स में यहाँ पे मिस्टेक है, ये अमॉर्फस वर्ड होना चाहिए. हम लोग अभी सिर्फ क्रिस्टलाइन की बात करेंगे. क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड्स में फर्स्ट टाइप इज आयोनिक क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड. आयोनिक क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड का सेकंड टाइप ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइन इज कोवेलेंट, थर्ड इज मॉलिक्यूलर एंड फोर्थ इज मेटालिक. इसमें मॉलिक्यूलर क्रिस्टल के फिर थ्री टाइप्स आते हैं, पोलर, नॉन पोलर एंड हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डेड. So I will just rectify this. Give me one second. This should be amorphous solids. So once again, the classification you can quickly see. So far we have seen only the first level of classification. We saw crystalline. We saw amorphous. And we saw the characteristics of them. So currently we are going to start with ionic, covalent, molecular, metallic and these three types. So when we see this, our unit one of the topic will be over. So let us now begin with the first type, that is ionic crystal. Perhaps from the name you can gather what is ionic crystal. They will have ionic bond between them and they will contain obviously ions. Like sodium chloride kind of thing. So the structural unit will be cations and anions. For example, this is a crystalline structure of sodium chloride. Here they will be connected with strong electrostatic force of attraction, that means ionic bond, and they will arrange themselves in such a way that force of attraction can become as strong as possible. So if you see perhaps one sodium here, it is getting covered from all the direction by chloride. देखो आप ये सामने देखोगे तो यहाँ पे क्लोराइड दिखेगा, इस तरफ देखोगे यहाँ पे क्लोराइड दिखेगा, नॉर्थ साउथ देखोगे आपको क्लोराइड दिखेगा. सो वन सोडियम इज गेटिंग कवर्ड बाय ऑलमोस्ट एक्स एक्सिस, वाई एक्सिस, जेड एक्सिस, ऑल द डायरेक्शन बाय क्लोराइड. दिस टाइप ऑफ क्रिस्टल्स आर कॉल्ड आयोनिक क्रिस्टल्स. लेट अस सी सम कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ देम. They will have very high melting point because the ionic bond breaking is little difficult at low temperature. These solids will not conduct electricity in solid state because ions are fixed at their points. They can conduct electricity in molten state or in aqueous state because once they will dissolve, bonds will break away, ions will become separate, and they can then freely conduct electricity. They are usually very hard, but sometimes they can be brittle also. We say they are hard, but when hammering is done, they will just break away into powder. Examples, we know any ionic salt you can write here as an example, NaCl, KCl, potassium sulfate, calcium fluoride, anything. It should be just ionic compound. Go through this. Any point, doubt about this part? These are all asked as short notes in your boards and true false statement, identify correct statement in MCQs, JE NEET also. Yesterday there was first paper of JE, the third attempt. It was, I will say, as same level as MHCET. Itna simple paper maine JE ka kabhi dekha nahi. I think only two questions were tough. बाकी पूरा पेपर एकदम इजी था केमिस्ट्री का. आई गॉट ओनली मॉर्निंग पेपर, इवनिंग पेपर नहीं मिला मुझे. बाकी का तो मैं हाउ कैन आई कमेंट, आई डोंट नो. फिजिक्स मैथ्स का तो मैं देख के भी मुझे समझेगा नहीं कि इजी है टफ है, वो तो आपको टीचर्स को आपको पता रहता है. आई कैन ओनली ऑफिशियली कमेंट ऑन केमिस्ट्री. चलो सेकेंड इज कोवैलेंट क्रिस्टल्स. सो कोवैलेंट सॉलिड्स में दी constituent particles will be atoms and what is present will be covalent bonds between them. Now when covalent bonds are present in these 3D structures, they will be really very strong. They will be really very strong. Best examples which are seen are diamond, graphite, silicon carbide, etc. Abhi isme se ye aapke paas structure hai diamond ka. You can see this is a tetrahedral structure. And you, if you see, this is one carbon atom connected like a tetrahedral, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Every carbon is sp3 hybrid. If you compare this with a graphite structure, this is sp2 hybrid structure. So every carbon is connected to only 3 carbon atoms. This becomes one layer, flat layer of carbon atoms. Fir ye second layer hai. और ये दो लेयर्स के बीच में फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इज प्रेजेंट. सो द कोवैलेंट बॉन्ड व्हाट यू सी हियर दैट विल बी स्ट्रॉन्ग, बट द फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन द लेयर्स विल बी डेफिनेटली वीक. दैट इज व्हाई ग्रेफाइट इज वेरी स्मूथ मटेरियल एंड वी कैन यूज दिस इन अवर राइटिंग पेंसिल्स. सो हम लोग पेंसिल से जो पेपर पे लिख सकते हैं वो ये वीक फोर्सेस की वजह से. That is why graphite can be powdered easily as you are writing it, scratching it on the paper. So this becomes example of covalent crystals. Since the network can be extended at infinite level, abhi hum log ne chota picture dikhaya hai carbon ka, diamond ka. This will extend at a very high level also. That's why they are called giant network solids or giant molecules. Haan, bolo.
Sir, is lead also used in pencils?
In ancient Greece, they used to make pencils with lead, actual lead, PB, in Greece. like before Christ time. That's why the term lead pencils have come. So actually lead stopped almost, I think, maybe 500 years back or something. But the name has remained as lead pencil. But we don't use lead at all in pencil. It's poisonous. You cannot use it. Ancient Greek people used to, pencil ka jab discovery hua tha, to unhone lead ke rods bana ke, usko silk se ya kisi cloth se bandhte the. Aur usse wo log likhte the. Papyrus, papyrus usko bolte. Papyrus, matlab paper ka original format. To uspe wo log likhte the. That's how the term lead has come. But abhi lead use hi nahi hota hai kahin pe. Okay. You should read history of pencils, how it developed over so many years and how pencils are made. It's very interesting. Chalo, let us see the characteristics of this. Perhaps another similar thing which has come from Greek thing is, Kisa, you can close your camera, please. Is another thing is the term plumber. Everyone knows what is a plumber? Indian, some log usko plumber. Indian log plumber kehte. English pronunciation is plumber. The person who comes and fits our pipes and everything. So why the term plumber or plumber is there? Because in ancient Greek civilization, they used to have pipes made up of lead. And lead in Greek language is called plumbus. So lead pipe ko theek karne wala, the person is called plumber. So the name has come. Now, today we don't have lead pipes actually in our bathrooms and all. But the term has remained from Greek civilization till today. So let us see, continue further. Characteristics of covalent crystals. Constituent particles are obviously going to be atoms only over here. Strong covalent bonds will be there. Three-dimensional network, and it's called a giant molecule. Very hard compared to ionic. Impossible that you can compress them. They are extremely hard. Very high melting and boiling point. Abhi graphite or diamond ka melting boiling point dekhoge, wo to 3000 ke upar rehta hai. Since it is a covalent bonding, their electrons are not freely available. So most of the crystalline solids or covalent solids, they will be poor conductors of heat and electricity. Abhi iske liye ek exception hai yahan pe, jo hum log ne abhi dekha tha. That is graphite. Graphite mein कार्बन का हाइब्रिडाइजेशन है sp2. सो व्हेन इट अंडरगोज sp2 हाइब्रिडाइजेशन, द लास्ट pz ऑर्बिटल का इलेक्ट्रॉन रिमेन्स फ्री एंड दैट इलेक्ट्रॉन कैन बी यूज्ड फॉर इलेक्ट्रिकल कंडक्शन. इसलिए डायमंड इज अ बैड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, बट ग्रेफाइट इज अ गुड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी.
So incompressible matlab ki like by home hands ya what?
Any by machine also. If you try to compress with a machine also, it's not going to be compressible very easily.
So can you please explain the repeat the reason?
Which reason? Which one?
So that d orbital.
So the electricity.
PZ
orbital. Oh, acha. Okay. Graphite ka electrical conduction you mean? So let us revisit our hybridization concept quickly here. We have carbon's configuration when we write it in ground state. Bahut din baad sun rahe ho aap log ye. So this is 2s2, and in 2p we have only two electrons. In excited state, one of the electron goes over here. This is the excited state of carbon. So in graphite, it's going to be sp2 hybridization. This is that electron which remains free electron. So this electron can be used for electrical conductivity. When you consider diamond over here, it will undergo sp3 hybridization. All the electrons are involved in bond formation. No free electrons possible. So diamond is a bad conductor of electricity. Have you all understood this?
So, but on high pressure, graphite becomes diamond, so that is compressible.
Oh, that particular pressure is not, we cannot do it. In fact, that is usually done naturally. Matlab earth ke crust mein hota hai wo, ekdam down the earth. So, this is not practically possible very easily. मतलब इतना प्रेशर लगा सकते हैं, नहीं ऐसी बात नहीं है, लेकिन थोड़ा प्रैक्टिकली इम्पॉसिबल है वो. दैट्स वाई लाइक नेचर में वो लोग क्या कहते हैं, डिस्कवरी करते हैं तो कि पहले शायद नेचर में ग्रेफाइट ही बना था, एंड ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम दैट पर्टिकुलर ग्रेफाइट ड्यू टू प्रेशर एंड हीट चेंजेस इन द अर्थ सेंटर स्लोली गॉट कन्वर्टेड इन टू डायमंड. ओके, सो डायमंड इज नॉट अ नेचुरल एलोट्रॉप ऑफ कार्बन. इफ यू रिमेंबर थर्मोडायनामिक्स में हम लोग ने देखा था ग्रेफाइट इज द नेचुरल स्टेट ऑफ कार्बन नॉट डायमंड.
उसका स्क्रीनशॉट ना लेना.
नहीं नहीं नॉट रिक्वायर्ड, नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. वो तो केमिकल बॉन्डिंग. कार्बोरंडम मालूम है किसी को? एनीबडी हैज हर्ड? सिलिकॉन और कार्बन का मिक्सचर, दिस इज कॉल्ड कार्बोरंडम, विच इज अ सिंथेटिकली हार्डेस्ट सब्सटेंस. नेचुरली हार्डेस्ट सब्सटेंस है डायमंड, और सिंथेटिकली हार्डेस्ट सब्सटेंस है सिलिकॉन कार्बन कॉम्बिनेशन वाला कंपाउंड कार्बोरंडम. So we come to the third type, that is molecular crystals. Now here the particles will be molecules. जैसे हम लोग ने आइस सुना था पहले, तो आइस में अपने constituent particles है H2O molecule. So that is called molecular crystal. So you can see examples like when chlorine, methane, hydrogen, all these gaseous substances, when we cool them and when we turn them into a solid, they will be called molecular crystals. तो वहां पे आपका स्मॉलेस्ट पार्टिकल इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी एटम और नॉट गोइंग टू बी एनी अदर आयन, इट विल बी अ मॉलिक्यूल इटसेल्फ. सो दे विल बी क्लासिफाइड डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द फोर्सेस ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इन देम. फर्स्ट टाइप नॉन पोलर, देन पोलर, एंड देन हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डेड. सो लेट अस सी दिस इन डिटेल नाउ वन बाय वन. सबसे पहले है व्हाट इज अ पोलर. आई एम रिपीटिंग इट फ्रॉम अवर केमिकल बॉन्डिंग चैप्टर. If you remember, we have a molecule, suppose AB, and there is a difference in electronegativity between them. So this unit is called a dipole. And the force of attraction between one dipole and another dipole is called dipole-dipole attraction. If a solid is made like this, it will be called polar molecular solid. So substances like HCl, sulfur dioxide, when convert into solid, they will have this type of force of attraction, dipole-dipole interaction. You know, these are going to be comparatively soft, again, bad conductor of electricity. Their melting points will be higher than non-polar molecular solid. Jo second type hum log karenge, usse inka value thoda higher rahega. एग्जाम के लिए आपको ये सिर्फ जो लेफ्ट साइड का कॉलम है वही बायहार्ट करना है. ये जो राइट वाला है ये खाली आपके समझने के लिए दे, ये एग्जाम में नहीं आएगा. प्लीज गो थ्रू इट वंस अगेन बिफोर आई गो अहेड. Shall we go ahead? Done. Polar ke exactly opposite, now we will see non-polar. So in non-polar, we will have molecules which cannot be polar at all. Simple. Like H2, Cl2, I2. They do not have any electronegativity difference. Also, if argon or helium, they are present, they also will be non-polar covalent. So they will have a force of attraction which we had seen long back in 11th standard, London force of attraction, also known as weak dispersion force of attraction. They also are comparatively soft, non-conductor of electricity, low melting point compared to the polar molecular solids. Remember, ye sab hum log gaseous substance ko jab hum log solid mein convert karenge, tabhi possible hai. So room temperature pe ye to hona bahut difficult hai. They will be at cold conditions only. अभी जो पोलर सॉलिड्स देखे थे उसी का थर्ड टाइप इज स्पेशल केस ऑफ डाइपोल वेयर हाइड्रोजन इज प्रेजेंट एंड वी कॉल दिस एज द हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग. जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल वाटर मॉलिक्यूल फर्स्ट एंड वाटर मॉलिक्यूल सेकंड में हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड प्रेजेंट है. सो यही डाइपोल डाइपोल अट्रैक्शन को जब हाइड्रोजन इन्वॉल्व होगा तो हम लोग उसको कहेंगे हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डेड सॉलिड्स. हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड यूजुअली सिर्फ थ्री एलिमेंट्स के साथ आपको दिखेगा, फ्लोरीन, ऑक्सीजन, नाइट्रोजन. सो इनके जो कंपाउंड्स रहेंगे जैसे HF, वाटर, NH3, व्हेन दे गो इन द सॉलिड स्टेट दे विल हैव हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डेड. दे आर ऑल्सो बैड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, सॉफ्ट सॉलिड एट रूम टेम्परेचर. Here also these last columns are only for your understanding.
So here HCl and HBr won't be considered.
HCl and HBr also can be considered. If they go in solid state, they will become under this part. If they wherever you have a dipole, first type is dipole. And if a dipole contains hydrogen, that same thing is called hydrogen bonded. The fourth type we come across is metallic crystal. So, सबसे पहले हम लोग ने देखा ionic, second देखा covalent, third देखा molecular, and now fourth one metallic. Obviously, as the name suggests, this will contain metal atoms, and the bonds present between them are called metallic bond. अभी metal का जो bond होता है वो ना तो ionic है ना covalent, it's a different type altogether. What they suggest is metal atom can lose electrons very easily even at room temperature because of the low ionization enthalpy. So metal mein se agar electron nikal gaya to there will be metal ions remaining freely. Those metal ions were termed as kernels. This is somewhat the picture will look like of any metal at room temperature. So ye metal ion hai और उसके जो फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स है वो बाहर ऐसे घूम रहे हैं. दिस वॉज इन फैक्ट टर्म्ड एज सी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. सो उन्होंने ऐसे सोचा कि इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्री है, वो घूम रहे हैं, मोबाइल है, और उसके अंदर मेटल कैटायंस प्रेजेंट है. अभी ये जो इलेक्ट्रॉन और मेटल कैटायन है बिटवीन देम वॉट एवर फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इज प्रेजेंट इज कॉल्ड मेटालिक बॉन्ड. यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड metallic bond is not going to be fixed. Metallic bond is mobile. So electron comes in the vicinity of the cation, bond is created. Electron goes out somewhere, the bond is broken. So metallic bond is not a fixed bond like covalent bonds. So under characteristics you can see, since lot of free electrons are present, electrical conductivity will be extremely high in metals. Other properties you have studied in school, malleability, ductility, all these things are present. They will also show luster and color in certain cases. Melting and boiling point depends upon valence electron. For example, sodium will produce lesser electrons compared to magnesium. That will create lesser compared to aluminium. So you can see ionic charge increases, size decreases, attraction increases, melting boiling point increases. So compared to sodium, melting point of magnesium will be higher, aluminium will be still higher. So jitne zyada electron free ho jayenge utna aapka melting boiling point increase hoga. Finally, we summarize all these points of the four types. This is a table beautifully made in NCERT. ऐसा ही सिमिलर टेबल आपके टेक्स्ट बुक में भी है, बट आई फेल्ट इसमें थोड़ा ज्यादा अच्छा डिटेल्स है कंपेयर टू अवर जीटीबी, सो आई हैव जस्ट टेकन दिस टेबल. सबसे पहले उन्होंने टाइप दिया है मॉलिक्यूलर सॉलिड्स. थ्री टाइप्स यू कैन सी, नॉन पोलर, पोलर, हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड. कंस्टिट्यूएंट पार्टिकल्स देखो कौन से है, सब जगह पे है मॉलिक्यूल. हर एक में फोर्स अलग है. देखो नॉन पोलर में कौन सा फोर्स है, पोलर में कौन सा फोर्स है, हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग में कौन सा फोर्स है. Few examples, soft है या hard है, electrical conductivity कैसी है इनकी, and melting boiling point कैसा है, is a very good summary you can see. Second is ionic solids, ions are present, force of attraction will be electrostatic. Examples तो आप लिख सकते हो, hard है but brittle, that's what I told you earlier, insulator in solid state but conductor in molten and aqueous. Melting points are going to be high. third type is metallic. Positive ions in the sea of free electrons. Metallic bond, hard malleable ductile, conductor in any state, melting point fairly high. And last type, covalent solids. Atoms, covalent bond is present. We saw example of diamond and graphite. अभी इसमें उन्होंने देखो कैसे एक्सेप्शन दो दिया है. क्वार्ट्ज, सिलिकॉन कार्बाइड, इसको हम लोग ने नाम दिया था कार्बोरेंडम, डायमंड, एल्यूमिनियम नाइट्राइड, यहां तक हार्ड है, इंसुलेटर है. एक एक्सेप्शन ग्रेफाइट का अलग से लिखा है, देखो सॉफ्ट है और एक्सेप्शन कंडक्टर, मेल्टिंग पॉइंट वेरी हाई. दैट इज द एक्यूरेसी ऑफ एनसीईआरटी. इसके लिए आई लाइक दैट पार्ट, इसलिए मैंने आपको जीटीबी वाला नहीं दिया. ये बहुत अच्छा लगा मुझे, परफेक्टली थिंक की बनी.